Alright, welcome back to part 2 of the Agamemnon Game Review Warlock Journal. Today's broadcast is being recorded on the 30th of August, 2018, Thursday, 6:19 p.m. Eastern Daylight Savings Time. The actual video was shot on the 22nd of August, 2018. Again, it's part 2. Just joining us from part 1. We backtracked a little on the clip here so you can not miss a beat. We're hunting these, I call them armadillo guys. But, part of this competition for game hunting, we always have to prove ourselves, even though we game hunted with this guy. Actually, it's the first time we probably met the guy, but, in the lore, it's always having to prove ourselves to this guy. Of course, the dialogue might be different if you actually had been with him on all of the 5 different continents. How do you say that? Ankylodon? One of the benefits of it's been, I stream out of Florida, so it's been stormy the last couple of days. There's some type of tropical depression forming out in the Gulf, but so what has happened is during the day, early part of the day, it's like warm, but then the clouds come in the later part of the day, and that's when all the storms happen. So from like 4 in the afternoon till about 8 o'clock at night, it's very stormy. A lot of lightning. But shortly after that, the temperature drops to about 75 degrees from like 90 degrees Fahrenheit. So it's actually quite comfortable at night. The last couple of nights, it's been that way. So. In Florida, storms are kind of weird. Weird. But a lot of times the storms in Florida, whatever the, say, the dominant weather is for like this part of the eastern seaboard, part of the United States. In Florida, it tends to have the opposite reaction. So, like, in other parts of the... the eastern seaboard, where it's, like, not pleasant, in Florida, it becomes very pleasant. It's weird. Good for us, bad for everyone else. So I decided to take that last wave down as a group, just to finish out the story really, the quest really fast. Where it says die, 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 Matrodon. I wonder if that's a play on the Beach Boys song, Barbaran. So it's ba 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 Barbaran. Here's the other guy. Ranger Palu. Is that Palu or Pelu? Gotta go find the other guy. After we finish killing off these dudes. Reptiles sleep a lot. That one's done. So I need to go find this other guy. I think this is going to be the last voiceover we do for today. Gives me enough time to process one or two videos and upload it to YouTube before I have to record to tonight's footage. Actually, we'll probably end up just processing the video, but I probably won't be able to upload it to YouTube till after 10 o'clock. Probably after midnight. Yeah. But processing videos is a lot of fun. I kind of think of it as a hobby at this point, an expensive hobby. And, passes the time. Found that guy, now we're headed back to the mission giver. I felt that the tail end of this quest line, it picked up in action. It started off slow, monotonous, kind of, and then it picks up, which is kind of fun. Even though that exclamation point is shiny, I tend to do the question marks first and then go grab them. That way we're clearing out our quest pad before we take on new tasks. I like having my quest log nice and clean and organized. guys that strung up. These two guys were the ones that were talking all tough. Look at them hanging, dangling from the air. A thorn in the side. Dun dun. Now, as we're on our way to do this other thing, we went ahead and grabbed this mission. Two missions. Basically, hunt these two things down. I believe they send you out to find this dwarf.
Go carefully.
Okay, first we decided to take care of these, take out the two game, and then we'll go find the guy. This guy kept spamming a shadow lock. Remember, it's important to keep your rotation up. We gotta take out this other guy. This was a tricky one because we had to deal with two of these guys. I think we end up dying. That's what happens. This is the battle I'm thinking about. I didn't realize the Void Walker had died, is what I think was going on. And then I started taking a lot of damage. Of course, I could be thinking about another battle. Yeah, see, he died. And I started taking a lot of damage. I know I need to get these guys casted fast so they can draw aggro away from me. And I gotta keep that Void Walker alive. One down. Need to buy some time to get this Fel Guard up.
Don't waste my time.
He'll draw aggro away from me. Then I can get the Void Walker cast. One thing good about Demonologist is that the more demons you have out, the stronger you're going to be physically. Because you draw physical, your physicalness is through your soul link. So the more demons you can have out on the field, stronger you're gonna be. And, yeah, we took those guys down. Cool. Decide to head back north and turn these things in, I guess, on our way to deal with this other guy. Find out Nessing where he camp. Since we gotta go through the quest guy anyway. Looks like we just bypassed it. Went on to the next one. This is actually a pretty significant plot point coming up. It's the first time we realize someone's trying to kill us in the story. I like these little pop-up missions. They're not really quests, but they're tied to the area that you're in. And, I guess they're kind of cool. this mission too was kind of, it's all contained in this area, but you ended up walking back and forth a lot. And the ground was sort of, had low points, mid points, high points. Just getting to all the different mobs took a long time. Overall, I felt it went fairly quickly. The nesting wary guy, he was in this area, so. And money's money. Might as well get paid. So we're following along, and all these little clues keep guiding us on where a nesting wary is at. Drop my little artillery on these guys. See, when your position's being overrun by the enemy, always drop artillery on him. We're up to 78% of the way there. Go look at these clues. Guess this is 84%. finally made it over to where we're trying to get to. A clue. His favorite rifle. Didn't they have these feather viper dudes for in Burning Crusades, a little introductory video in the front? The warlock sucked all the life out of it. The coolest power the warlock has is sucking life out of people. As then you eat their corpse. That's the best. It's taking a long time to find this guy. This video, this part went a little longer, but I felt it was important to include these in this part of the clip rather than end it at 30 minutes and make another part. Wanted to contain it all within the same story arc. So here comes this guy. At this point in the story, we don't even realize someone's trying to kill us. I mean, literally set out to kill us. You know, I was that famous.
It's a fine day for a hunt.
These guys are supposed to be expert hunters, and they got caught. Head hunter Joe.
May your aim be true.
Calling us out like in the WWE. Smackdown here. But I too watch Smackdown, or used to. Now to bring out the big guns. It's best to bring out the big guns when the guy's getting weak at the end, and then you just keep getting stronger and stronger and stronger as the battle goes on. That's the best way to kill people. And then eat their corpse.
You can't beat the smell of fresh pine in the breeze. I'll be hunting.
So we cleared this guy out. And we headed back to camp. I believe we hit our Azeroth thing here. Decided to keep the staff. Because it looks like the staff itself has haste and mastery. Whereas when you get the other two weapons, you have to get the haste and mastery through the offhand object. think we rode back, right? Go back at the preserve. I believe this is where we hit our Azerite power.
I'm listening.
So, Azerite shard. Yep. New power available.
Zandala forever.
Gotta go all the way to the south there. So what we ended up doing is we ended up going back to the Horde camp. And this is where we selected our next Azerite power.
It is a day for flying. Ride the wind.
So here we go, back to camp. Not only did we get the Ezra, but I believe we leveled up to 112. Yeah. This is where I decided to call it a night. Go ahead and dump up all this junk. Clean out our bags. gear.
Spirits be with you, man.
And thus ended another day here at the Great Seal. Well, we'll be back for the next part, the 23rd of August, 2018. See you then. Have fun. Enjoy your day. And take care. Bye-bye.